for this summer school. I would like to thank again the organizers. It was very unusual or extraordinary hospitality. So I experienced such a level of hospitality only when I came for a very short visit, maybe for half day, when they took care of every hour, but not for 2 weeks. So this was kind of, I experienced a very warm attitude, not only from organizers, also from participants, from staff, and just from population, and when people, same with my wife, she said when people see she is with a map looking for something, so they try to help, even they could not explain, so they Also here I felt people very ready to help. For local people it is not a problem when they come with luggage and they leave with same luggage. But when people come from overseas, they buy presents. My wife bought a heavy statue of Buddha. And so it probably can be, we cannot take it with carry-on luggage, it is heavy. Can be used, so we put it in some other stuff, and so we were concerned if luggage is too heavy, and there was restriction 24 kilograms, and I remember there should be, or logically, there should be scale in the spa to check it, but it is, I asked permission from desk people, they permitted, and I didn't realize that actually scale was, I was the only person with this heavy luggage, all people around very naked or half naked, but there was no problem, so even such a weird action were welcome, so this, so thanks again. So this is this actually my name tag survived till the last day, and so but it is, was broken. I tried to fix it. So this is me, but I okay. So and here now I can see it. And so first page actually I fixed what I said last time. Everything was correct, but I when I tried to use. So you see same notation. So U was a solution with a zero, I use this way, zero here, positive on half top of boundary, zero on the bottom half top, bottom half, so this is x2 plus means positive here, zero here. V is reflected. And when we take W, U minus V, by symmetry, we automatically had W0 here, positive here, and then also harmonic. But when I wanted to apply this, I somehow thought about the whole ball. Everything is good because I'm applying the boundary Harnack principle in half ball. At the bottom, both V and W vanish. So V was not vanishing on the whole ball, but I don't need it. So what is here, W is something what comes in addition when we compare U and with the symmetric part. And I want to show that this ratio is strictly bigger. So when I apply it, I apply maximum or this boundary Harnack principle. Some people call it comparison principle to this ratio in half ball. And we have zero in a bigger half ball. And I call this constant 1 over C. And then V is restored from W is U is double V plus W. And when we estimate infimum U over V, I want to show that this is strictly bigger than 1. So I write it like this. U is V plus W divided by V, I have exactly this way. And so supremum V over W is bounded from above, so infimum of reversed or reciprocal fraction V over W bounded by below, but bounded by constant which is strictly bigger than 1. So this is in upper half ball. In lower half ball, by symmetry, So these kind of symmetric, mutually symmetric. If I go to lower half ball, I need to interchange U and V. Then I get, by symmetry, I have same relation here as I had here. Then I put upside down, then I get the estimate from above, and now what you see, UV ratio is the same, but in upper half ball it is strictly bigger than one, strictly bigger. In lower half ball it is strictly less than one, so it must be discontinuous. This was, everything what I wrote was correct. So it was a kind of cheap consequence. Now, I continue, or actually not continue, I'm going today to talk about what would be parabolic version. I will, but summarizing some of techniques which I use, it can be in, done in kind of more general setting. If I consider cylinder, introduce cylinder type domain, so maybe let me first just show examples. So you will, if you look at this, you may not see why it is cylinder. Let me go to next page. Example like this. These are two examples of harmonic functions. One, both examples are two-dimensional, but of course this can be done in a higher dimension as well. Example one is when we have, what we have here, it is a real part of exponent z. Z is x1, same as in second example, x1 plus ix2, and real and imaginary part of any analytic function are harmonic, and here you can check it directly. Second derivative in x1 is same function, and in x2 it is minus, so Laplacian is zero. And I took cylinder, this is actually in one dimension horizontal strip, so x2 is between minus pi over 2 and pi over 2, exactly where cosine is positive. Cosine 0 on the boundary, so we have positive function here, 0 on the boundary. And so if you just look at it, you can see when you go to infinity or to minus infinity, actually you can put here also linear combination, C1 exponent x1 and C2 exponent x2, and have function like this. But I do it just to show how it increases in the x1 direction. So it increases exponentially. And if you put here a general operator, what is really needed when we apply maximum principle, we can proceed with the steps of length R0. And what is needed here when we take intersection with ball of radius R0 at each step, we need to have a complement has measure comparable to measure of ball. And here it works if I take R0 is pi. It is not enough to have pi over 2, because if I take center at x1 axis, the whole ball lies completely inside. So this is a cylinder, and the rate of growth or decay is exponential. And for second example, it is a cone, and here function and in two dimension we cannot have much flexibility, so here rate of growth gamma should be not too small, so theta zero is not higher, not bigger than pi. But you, what you can see from here, and also this is maybe demonstration for interior or exterior condition. Here we again have an analytic function, but it appears as real part of z power gamma, which is well defined if you use exponent, but and we choose one of branches, because if we write as exponent, we need to put logarithm of that, and logarithm is multivalued function. And if I write it in terms of theta is angle, I choose a range of between minus pi over 2, minus theta 0 to theta 0. And so if gamma is bigger than 1, this picture corresponds to case when gamma is bigger than 1. So theta 0 is less than 0. We have a cone. And again, a function like this is harmonic inside of cone, and also outside, if you don't care how we extend it. And also positive inside and zero on the boundary. But now, if we see, want to check how fast it is growing, and we also can use Gross lemma. In fact, we also have estimate from below if you iterate Harnack. But the difference here, if you want to iterate, we can increase step as we go away. This what happened when we considered Lipschitz domain or John domain. We had twisted cone, and when we went away, we did iteration in such a, it was hidden implicitly. But this is why we had more weight like distance to some power. It comes for domain which we can describe as cone domain. These are explicit examples for which we can see that this rate is sharp. I mean, so what can we say about you? If you approach to the origin from a big radius, we see you approaches to zero with some power rate. And so you also see, by the way, here, if the best case, if gamma is 1. Gamma is 1, we have just half half plane, and in that case, u x1 is just x1. It is nice function for which we have both estimate for gradient from below, or growth in x1 direction from below and from above. If it make it smaller, we cannot touch the origin by ball from inside, and also there is no hope for the Alenikopf estimate. We have growth or decay here r power gamma if you go in direction along x1 axis, theta is 0, and here x1 power gamma and gamma bigger than 1. So it approaches to 0 horizontally. If you make gamma bigger, less than 1/2, so we will have reversed cone, and then we have estimate from below, but not have estimate from above. And in that case, we cannot touch the origin from outside by a ball. And I discussed also last time that a sharp condition would be not ball, would be paraboloid, satisfying integral condition. If I write it separately, it would be if graph is described by function psi, we need to write, I will use it from time to time, sharp condition for which we have, will be like this. So it is this way. So x prime is in R n minus 1. X n is vertical. Domain D is where xn bigger than psi. X prime, and I assume it is spherically symmetric like this. Psi increases, and necessary sufficient condition. Did it disconnect?
Yeah, it's just the hovering. Hovering over this and that, I think. But you can try it again.
Okay.
The spot.
Oh, so what is happens? Is it metallic or maybe?
Something like that. But for a moment, let's. Okay.
Or only this. This is small room. Maybe we don't need this microphone. Okay. So I will speak a little bit louder. But room is Okay, so what is here? This is monotone because otherwise if you have bumps, it is harder to control. But if you have it like this, we can approximate by steps and apply here version of Boundary-Harnack principle when we have just a denominator xn. And so necessary and sufficient condition would be integral from zero to something because singularity is at zero, psi of r dr over r square. If it is finite, then we have our estimate for growth linear from below. If complement can be touched by such paraboloid, then we have estimate for gradient from above. If not, we don't have it. So it both example and counterexample. So this is what we have. Okay, so this is how just examples which may help to understand better. Why such notations? I think this terminology was introduced by Landis. I heard about this in his lectures, but I couldn't find exact reference. And you see what is typical for cylinder here. And I'm talking about it because in the proof of Boundary-Harnack principle in full generality for John domain, I used this trick that when I approached the boundary by horizontal layers, one rate of distance to the boundary was hk was 2 minus k, and in horizontal direction it was much slower, like k minus 1. And so when I did iteration, I had a super fast growth or decay just because it was this thin layer was a kind of cylindrical type domain. And so when we iterated many times, we got exponential decay, which is much faster than power decay. So this is something like in horizontal direction, we approach zero much faster than we approach in directly to the boundary. And so here, I try to use notation similar, but there is still a difference. You see, what is for cylindrical, cylinder type domain? The center, R0 is fixed. So in the example which I just showed, it was pi for each point. For each point, when we take intersection, we have measure strictly less than measure of ball. So there exists a radius and such that mu is a fixed portion of a measure. I use it both mu zero for cylinder type and cone type domain. But for cylinder type, center is arbitrary. For cone type domain, center is fixed. You see, in one case, we have for each x0. And for cone domain, there exists x0, which is fixed. Mu zero in both cases is constant, same, and also condition looks similar, but another difference. For cylinder type domain, R0 is fixed, there exists. For cone time domain, for each R, we have it. So if you just think of a cylinder and cone, we have it like this. And condition, what we used, look exactly like this. And so when we use iterate what I call the gross lemma, this decay depends on how many times we can iterate. For cylinder type domain iteration, we can proceed with same step. And so this is, I notice it is a mistake. When we do iteration, so here when we do iteration, it is should be like this. R is bigger and R0 like this. Okay, R0, okay, because we cannot do iteration if radius is less than R0. We only in that case, if you look again at example, if you take radius smaller than R0, you cannot guarantee decay. So iteration actually goes away. And so don't care of this. So this is how it looks like. For quantum domain, we have something, and constant does not depend on structure, depends only on constant which appear in cylinder type domain. For quantum type domain, we have decay like power, which I used, I did it for Lipschitz domain or John domain, we had it like this, but I considered for certainty that U is positive, and we can apply those arguments separately to subset where U is positive and or U is negative. Since x0 here is fixed, the complement becomes even bigger, so no problem if you do it separately for positive and negative part. So this is what was when we deal with elliptic case. There are some similar ideas in parabolic case, but they require some maybe more adjustment. And what it is, let's see, so this is this page, second, third is example. So I formulated in a primitive setting, so many people may be bored. Let me see. Fact, maybe this corner is not visible. If I move it this way. Okay. Okay. So it is trivial. I just want to emphasize that I consider parabolic equation as they understood in theory of partial differential equation. So minus in front of derivative. And correspondingly, and then for cylinder, initial data would be at the bottom of cylinder. In probability, very usual when we have plus here, but then trajectory goes up and data are given at the top of cylinder, if you consider cylinder. And this is actually, when we talk about parabolic equations, so what we have here, it can be also considered as elliptic degenerate equation. When we have diffusion, which is degenerate in one direction, which we call t direction, corresponds to time. In my choice, coefficient, we don't have diffusion in t direction. We have only drift, and coefficient in front of this derivative says that we have unit velocity of this process in t direction. That means when we start, I use notation x capital for when we have both t and x small component. A small component for x capital is x small. So x0 is actually x, let me write, so x0 has component, so t0, x0 small. So this is what I'm using. And it formula in this case requires only first derivative in t direction. And normally, in order to apply it formula, we need continuity only for those derivatives which appear in equation. So this is helpful when equation is degenerate. If it happens, for example, that diffusion is just vanishes at some set, we don't need anything on this set. When we apply it, we need, but for x we need, so this notation means here, everywhere, t is a first variable, which I can think as zero component of, and then x, x1, x2, and so on. And all notations are correspond to this. If I write C12, that means C1 with respect to T, which is the first component of X capital, and C2 with respect to X. Continuous up to the boundary, just to have a nice avoid singularities at the boundary. And if you have such a classical solution in set Q, here it is a bounded set, and U is G on the boundary, but not on the whole boundary, in fact. When we deal with the parabolic case, it is enough to consider only parabolic boundary. And what it is, if in analytic term, if we don't involve stochastics, point y0, so you see I use y capital for boundary point, to reserve x0 for interior point where we start, initial point for a process xt when t is 0. So then t small 0 is just 0. Okay, T0. So parabolic boundary, it is written here. Y0 belongs to parabolic boundary if it is on the boundary, but it cannot be here. This portion not on parabolic boundary, because what we say, there should be a continuous function defined on some interval. Delta depends on choice of function, delta depends on Y0. For here, we cannot go further. If we try to construct such function, we go outside of domain. And so if you write it this way, it is initial point S0, Y0 is on the boundary. But then, so this is Y0, but I use notation S. This should be YT. So this is, let me see, Y small t, component of Y capital. And it is clear from probabilistic point of view that if you use representation, if you have a for simplicity like this, then we have same probabilistic representation, U is expectation of tau exit time, expectation starting from x capital 0, g x tau is g is u is g on the boundary, so I can put here also u x tau. And also strong mark of process property says that here if I put u x tau, it's still true for any stopping time before exit time, and here tau is exit time out of d. And so xt, you see, I told it, T component is just, we have constant drift in T direction, so velocity going down to bottom. In xt, it is a stochastic equation, but now we have x diffusion, and B depends on x capital. And relation same as we had in elliptic case, diffusion matrix, but now it is correspond to second derivatives only, it is 1/2 sigma sigma t, and we have operator same as here. B is drift. But once again, we can think of it as degenerate elliptic when we have one more component in drift, which is minus 1 in t direction, no diffusion in x. And from here, since u is g on the boundary, automatically we get supremum is supremum on parabolic boundary. And also we may have inequalities if you write it a formula, but here is mainly a reminder that I treat parabolic equation in same way as in theory of PDE. I put minus here, but then values process goes down. If I change it direction of t, I put here a plus, and the process will go up. Not each point is, we cannot access, for example, any point here, because if you try to do it, we hit this obstacle and stop. So this is what makes a parabolic boundary maybe not quite nice if you think of it from analytic point of view, but from probabilistic representation, no problem. and we even don't need to specify it this way. Automatically we have, we cannot hit top, we cannot hit this border and so on. So this is, and here, when I talked about elliptic equation, I always assumed that matrix process is non-degenerate. I mean, matrix had eigenvalues between nu and nu minus 1. And next page, what is specific for parabolic equation? For elliptic equation, if you have a strip of fixed widths, then decay or growth would be exponential. Example is what I gave, also works as if you stay away from the boundary, to read Harnack, we say have same estimate from below. This is what actually we did. For parabolic case, situation becomes different because time is not reversible. If we make a domain thin in t direction, that means if we have bounded diffusion, we have very small probability for a big deviation when time is short. I will formulate it explicitly. It is also, in fact, statement is trivial if you think something from probability, but also not hard if you do it in a purely analytical way. Here I don't care if my constants are sharp or not, but I want what I want to emphasize from the beginning. I don't assume that A is degenerate. You see, estimate only from above. In previous lectures, I assumed also bigger than nu times xi square. So it may be degenerate. It may be identically zero at some area. But if A is identically zero, then the process just goes vertically down. Doesn't go any. In that case, of course, we don't have deviation at all. But if you want to estimate deviation, then how I treat it in a probabilistic point of view. I will try. Let me draw a picture first. I will. Okay, so what I, this picture, primitive picture, cylinder T changes from zero to T capital. If I take U zero at the bottom, you see this is one of conditions, and consider process, so trajectory should be strictly monotone, but I'm not, if I consider a function of t, it is strictly decreasing. So this is a kind of Brownian trajectory on this whiteboard. And what happens if I do it here, zero here, then if I use a probabilistic representation, then u would be exactly probability to hit the boundary. The boundary, let me just show again what is here. In that case, Q is a cylinder which is on this whiteboard. If X tau hits the bottom, we get nothing. If X tau hits the lateral side, we get one. So in this representation, expectation, G is zero when we are at the bottom, G is one when we are at the lateral side. So this is exactly probability to hit a lateral side, and this is exactly probability that we will have deviation R on a time interval from zero to T or to T capital. And Gaussian estimate says here that if you have a situation like this, and this is my way to write same expression, so what is here, actually, if I put it together, what, so this is same as this. This is the way to write the same expression using D is symbolic vector derivatives. Here, for simplicity, I drop. So I consider B identical to zero. It requires something, but it looks especially simple if we have just...
You can go on.
Oh, this is...
Just for recording.
Yeah. So we have a possibly degenerate process without drift, but of course if you have bounded drift, what we know for sure, drift cannot bring us faster than maximum of B times T, easy to adjust it. So the main part is how to figure out that we have decay like this. If time is short, then here supremum, which we may assume it is maximum, and then we have a ratio of exponential decay, but when t appears in denominator. So if r is fixed, then it is very fast, and like Gaussian, Gaussian is like Gaussian density, something like x square over t, but of course without a factor in front of it. So here, why it makes sense to talk about such a situation? If we think of density in for Brownian motion or just for a standard Wiener process, density has Gaussian distribution, and same is true if time is fixed for equation in divergence form. Divergence form means if you formally interchange D and A here, divergence of A du. But for divergence case, it is known that there is also density, or called a Green function, or which is comparable to density of, actually it is squeezed between two densities, densities with big diffusion and small diffusion. And correspondingly, if we integrate, we get such estimate automatically. For then we need to integrate over to over exterior of ball of radius r, and then we have this tail which converges nicely, and this estimate for divergence case comes automatically because we have such estimate for density. For non-divergence case, there is something what looks like striking in contrast with what is known for it. Parabolic version of gross lemma, which I talked about in elliptic case, that there is always positive probability to hit set of positive measure before we exit bigger ball of some radius. If process is non-degenerate. In parabolic case, we have same thing, of course, assuming that the set, we start from point which is strictly above set of positive measure, then there is a positive probability to hit this set, and the probability depends only on characteristics of process, assuming it is non-degenerate. Of course, if A is identically zero, we just go vertically down, and if you have a small hole, we go through this hole and don't hit the process. But what looks like contrast, maybe can demonstrate it, what is... okay, but anyway, it is just general words. If we try to think in terms of density for operators like this, we have phenomena, even in one-dimensional case, when X is one-dimensional, non-degenerate, and moreover, we have singularity only near zero, but still A is continuous, but no Wölder or Dini continuity. We may have such phenomenon that if what we can call as density, it is actually singular or corresponding measure is singular with respect to Lebesgue measure. That means, if you think in terms of distribution of x tau, even for non-degenerate process, when we have a horizontal piece of boundary, distribution of x tau may be singular with respect to Lebesgue measure, which means process hit a set of zero measure with probability 1, which is impossible for a divergence case. So this is we constructed some counterexample also Phelps-Koenig and constructed similar examples which described like this. So that means to get an estimate this way, we should not talk at all about densities. Density is very bad. It is singular. But as it comes to integration, integral which correspond to probability behaves same way. And this is a nice fact which helps to control solutions much in the same way as in elliptic case, if you consider short cylinder, if time is short. So what it says, we have, so everything is written here. In probabilistic interpretation, if u is 1 on lateral side, 0 on the bottom, we have probability hit the lateral side, starting from 0 in time t. So we start from t and the process goes down, but in time t we hit t0. So t is actually here t0 when we think in such a term. Probability is of order small constant, which may be small, but expression is huge because t is in denominator. And decay is super fast, or looks like Gaussian. If we, for simplicity, I assume both this constant, which is small, and the same constant here. Because this phenomenon only for short time, if we are away, we may just estimate by maximum principle and replace by one. Okay, so this is a proof. Let me just say what a pretty standard, but and well known, but since not hard to find reference for the for degenerate case, we actually, there are some barrier functions, but they use non-degeneracy, and it is not needed. First, simple observation, when we do rescaling, to have same equation, we need to change, if we multiply x by constant, we need to multiply t by constant square. Then after differentiation, this constant will cancel. T constant square in front of dt, and because we differentiate twice, constant square, we have same equation. So we can assume r is 1, then we, and also multiply u by constant, also change sign, we can assume this is also 1. And so we need to show that we have u less than exponent minus beta over t when r is 1. So this is this line. So do such kind of preparation. Here, once again, so this is, I don't care that my estimate is sharp or not, I just want to have it with some small constant, therefore I take just the simplest thing. What makes W, so I want to have W is function, simplest function which is 1 at 0 and vanishes on the boundary of ball. I plug it inside in such a way, so it appears here constant which I specify later. T minus 1 W square, W is this function, I just want. When I differentiate in T, I just write using chain rule, it appears this way. Differentiate with respect to XI, I write it again by chain rule. In any case, we have, when we have exponent with inside of exponent something, it is hard to get rid of exponent. When we apply chain rule, exponent remains the same. So we have same function, and these additional terms come when we differentiate what is in this parenthesis in exponent. We have these two things. Okay, and then consider separately what happens when we apply differentiation in x only. X appears now a few times. It appears here, appears here, appears here. When we differentiate here and collect all the terms, differentiation this part, this gives me this expression. So this comes from differentiation of this part, and it is quadratic form, which I don't need. It is useful for a Moser type of technique, but here I just drop it. So this is something what is non-positive. And I take control of the rest. And the rest is when I differentiate derivative comes to this one, I get again the same kind of expression. This is why I get so this is what happens. So this another derivative comes from differentiation here, and it gives this expression. So square of this, and the rest is, so this is what comes differentiation here. And when it comes, differentiate this again, it is nice function, so I just put it this way, but of course it is just minus 2 twice trace of W. But I write it this way to show how it came. And then I estimate in very rough way. Everything here is bounded. W is nice function. This is also bounded. And so what I get, some constant, and zero, you can see I drop this. It is non-positive. Drop this. Then here I have 2C, parenthesis square. So this expression is square of this expression, as you can see. LW is less than constant. So if I estimate it by constant, you estimate it by Cauchy-Schwarz, I can put constant in front, but constant is prescribed, depending only on n and upper estimate for this matrix, which is nu minus 1. So then I have this plus 1 just to control everything in between, times function v, which was here. So this is what I get in Lx. Because I want to just show explicitly what I get when Lx is this portion of operator. And in T direction, I have something that looks similar, you see, T, but constant, not C square, constant is C. And then standard trick, in parabolic case, it helps a lot, we don't have similar tool in elliptic case. It is multiplication by exponent with N0T, and for me I can take just the same N0 and to choose constant C appropriately later. When I just apply chain rule, this is my operator which appears here, this is this operator applied to you. I applied this, you see, there is no V small here. You are right, yeah, no V small. Everything is here. Then this part, no, this is N0. I first wanted to take N1, but I can just take this way. So this is what it comes when I differentiate. This appears from differentiation of this exponent. And the rest is just the same operator applied to V. It is here. Oh, I need to, okay, so this is not V, it is would be exponent N0T. Because V is already inside. But now, in next expression, I collect it together. V capital comes from, so I collect together N0 V small, together this is V capital is outside. here dt contains this small, so I take just coefficient in front of t, so it contains this expression, but coefficient is c. And v small is here in v capital, so v small with this exponent is v capital, and this part is here, but now it is this is plus, and you see now if I take c small 1 over n 0, I will get cancellation here. So n0 already cancels, and this will cancel if I take c, so n0 is reasonably large, depends only on dimension and nu, upper bound if I take c small depending only on 0, I get estimate this way. And now use just either instead of saying use maximum principle, but maximum principle was formulated when we have zero. I just show how it comes from eta formula. Tau is exit time out of this cylinder. And so we start from x capital, u x tau, and this is less than v because on the boundary we have u is zero at the bottom, and I assumed supremum is 1, and v is, look at it again, what happens when we are on lateral side? On lateral side, w is 0, so here, at the bottom it is just positive, it is enough to have this control. On lateral side, w is 0, and therefore here in this exponent, v is just 1. And u is not bigger than 1 by my assumption. So it helped me to write it this way. After I do it, since function is nice, it is integrable, it may have singularity, but it is nice singularity when we approach 0. It infinitely differentiable. Exponent has singularity, but expression in exponent, but not exponent itself. Apply eta formula in usual way, so this is operation, operator, this is a drift component, if we think of it as an elliptic case. And this is called a barrier function also. By construction, this expression is non-positive, therefore what I get here is non-positive, less or equal 0, and therefore we have it this way. And so if I want to estimate it as I want it at t0, it is less than this. And now what is here, this is, I have this factor, and I have, when I plug x0, I have w is 1, and so when w is 1, I get expression like this. But for small t, this gives the main contribution. I even don't care to put what is explicit value. If I take beta small enough, depending on c, and c is actually 1 over n0, it is something like 3/4, but I don't care. But beta depends only on n0. So I have this estimate, which is exactly what I wanted, because r is 1, so this is r is 1, and this is estimate this way. So this is a Gaussian estimate, which helps to treat it in such. So what else we have here? I may say, so this is for recording. In addition, this is for microphone, and I wanted actually turn off and use kind of whiteboard. So this is estimate from above, and for estimate from below, let me use this part because it is called slant cylinder estimate. It is standard, and we used it many times, starting with our work with Krylov, and it was also, we borrowed it from Landis' work. And what it is, a slant cylinder. In order to have this estimate, this is estimate for probability, so we have like this, a disk. We stay at a positive distance, take a disk same size, and compose a cylinder of limited slope. So if everything is standard, let me just think this is ball radius 1, then this displacement is finite. So this is a disk at some positive distance. So, and we want to say that we go from this, from x0 here, consider process, and we want to estimate not from above, we want to estimate it from below. Estimate the probability that process goes through this disk and hits this. So this is something in elliptic variant. It was when we start from a ball, we can hit some neighbor ball if we stay at positive distance from the boundary. And this is also something like that. But in parabolic effect, we may need to navigate somehow. If we have such kind of estimate from below, so this is x tau, but now this is, for example, time t, and so x tau, so this is q is, in this case, is slant cylinder or inclined cylinder, and we want to find probability that x tau, or just let me say, tau is tau of q is t. That means we go all this way and exit time is here, but not on lateral side. If we hit lateral side, then it is not the case. So we want to have it like this. So if you want to use a comparison function, so if I write it explicitly, it would be boring. So let me do it in such a way. So this is, we have to shift it. So when we want to translate, we need to change it. So here, center actually, if I put it this way, we may have, at the axis, we have x is some L vector times t. L is a bounded vector. So when t is zero, it is here. And L, we can say actually x of, so this x zero becomes this projection of x zero when t is t capital. So x zero is L times t. But this is just how it looks like. So if you want to have estimate for u, it is now what kind of comparison function do we need? We need to estimate somehow this probability. Probability of tau q is t. And now take again same Wx. Here it is, if I want to have zero on the boundary, so Wx is again 1 minus x squared. Okay, and I will apply it to W squared. So this is W, which vanishes on the boundary. And this is bigger than expectation starting from point x0. And now I write W square of x, and it has actually two components, but if I just write x small tau, because what happens in this case, if x, we need to, bigger than W square X tau, assuming, let me take just to make sure that indicator, because tau may happen before and I don't want to indicator tau is T. Just because if I put 1, I have exactly probability, and this is something between 0 and 1. And then what should be appropriate comparison function? Comparison function would behave like this. If I write it in such a way, I need to have a comparison function which satisfies, okay, let me write W. So this, I just don't think, try to manipulate. Take W capital is a function. This is distance to the axis. X minus this W square, X minus T times L. So just do it like this. Then what happens if I want to estimate this estimate? So this estimated. This is, I need assumption, so if I write it this way, then of course this is W capital at X capital tau. Okay? Because if we hit the lateral side, on the lateral side, because I made this adjustment, this is distance from the axis. On the lateral side, this distance is 1, but when it is 1, W small is 0. Okay, so this is, and this function is nice when I plug it this way. And also, when T is 0, when we hit the bottom, we have tau is T, and this means we just take here T is 0, and this is exactly the case. So this is what we have, but as soon as we have this, what we need to use eta formula in right side, W of X capital, and if you get a desired sign, we will get the estimate, because, let me see, it is starting from X0, so this is from X0, plus expectation from X0, and now integral from 0 to tau. And here, I, since I go down, I have to write it as minus dtw plus lx of w dt. So if I want to have estimate from below, now I need, in the previous argument, when I estimated estimate from above, I need to have inequality like this. And now I want to have it this way. And then this would be bigger than W at X0. And what happens at X0? At X0, when we have it like this, this is just exponent minus, so W, here is a distance to the boundary, which is 1, and then this is becomes minus lambda t capital. So we have exponential, so estimate from below, but the question is what is lambda and if we can make it this way. Here, why it works? One can check directly that it works, but even without calculation, I don't want to just say what happens when we are close to the boundary. When we are close to the boundary, so W has a shape like this. This is W, and W square is something like this. Some people prefer to take cosine, or maybe even in our work with Krylov, maybe we took cosine. But idea is, when if you do it this way, we have we don't have a good control for second derivatives. But if we are close, then second derivative If one will take AIJ operator, give something strictly positive near the boundary. So we have LX double U is strictly positive if we have if we have near lateral side. Boundary is, so I write like this, D symbol X in X direction of this Q. Because if we compute it, so here we will have component minus, when we differentiate this part, it does not hurt. It will give us additional lambda times W, this portion, when, and when we stay away from, when we are close to the boundary, this derivative, the main, okay, let us just say what is, good part comes from here. When we differentiate this part, it is lambda times W. When we differentiate this in T, by chain rule, we will have something of this derivative, but it is multiplied by W. But if you are close to lateral side, then W is small. Same with first derivatives. If you differentiate one time, and we are close to the boundary, then W is factor here after differentiation. So it is small. So the main part comes when we differentiate it twice, and then we have use non-degeneracy. Now it is important that without this condition, we cannot do it. It was only in a previous argument like this. Okay, so this is needed. And of course, if you have degenerate process, we can just go vertically down without diffusion and don't hit it. Hit lateral side with probability one. Okay, so this is... okay, so this is... so if we are close to lateral side, we have sign, which is good, and have this inequality. And now what if we are away from the boundary? If you have distance, so this is some distance delta, zero, which we can estimate. But if we are away, all part here is bounded, but we can suppress everything by choice of lambda, because when we do it, it is, when we have, it contains, it starts when we differentiate here, well, I mean, we have component minus WT, minus derivative in T direction, and it is here. It starts from lambda times W. And since we can drop coefficient, it appears in all expression, but as soon when we are away from lateral side, W small is separated from zero. And now we can choose lambda big enough to have this expression is big. So this is big goes to, so we can make it plus something. What can be larger, bigger than zero, if distance is W bigger than some W zero positive. This is what happens if we away from the boundary. So together we have control and we have such a two-sided estimate. So together these tools in much as it is what my time I think is finished. So what is, let me just show, so these two tools combining, it, so this is one of main things, and also we can do kind of adjustment what we have, if we have drift, what we can get, let's see, parabolic version of boundary Harnack principle. to formulate it, we cannot write it in the same way, but it will be true if we have zero on the whole bilateral side. Let me just show one application to eigenvalue problem. Consider elliptic case. LU, but not zero right-hand side. Consider eigenvalue problem. Lambda U in domain D, and U is zero on the boundary. Okay, then what can we say? This is elliptic case, and if we introduce, so LU is, as I defined it, as A D DU. And now if I consider function U capital of Tx, exponent, let me, I usually sometimes take T in one direction, in other cases in another, but let me first take Tx, first take lambda T. If not true, I can always put minus. It is better than opposite way. Or ux, then what we get if I write minus dtu plus lxu, we always have a factor exponent lambda t, and what comes here, when we differentiate it in t, we have one component here, minus lambda u, and another plus lx u, and this is zero. And we don't have dependence on t at all. So this is zero. That means when we go to parabolic case, we have equation without lower order terms. These other terms disappeared. And this equation is in a cylinder. And it turns out if so cylinder is Lipschitz, we can formulate and prove estimate boundary Harnack principle in same way as, not it, formulation is in the same way if you have it zero on the boundary. And what it gives? It gives actually, so fact, so it is known that first eigenfunction is positive, and next are must change sign. And from here, if you write it, for first eigenvalue eigenfunction which is positive, and it remains positive, of course, like this, and compose ratio, put this eigenvalue denominator and for another eigenvalue to numerator. We have estimate for oscillation when we go for smaller to bigger cylinder. And this estimate of oscillation guarantees the gap between eigenvalues. This is something what in Evans' book was proved even for, under very special restrictions using not nice way if you can take this. And this comes for free. What is interesting, this was a joint work with Polyachik some time ago, and his student Huska, but we, in our recent work with Gong Chen, he's still an undergraduate student, and he is thinking which way to go, because next year I'm going to sabbatical, one of them maybe Carlos Koenig will take him, and he still has, but I out here, very likely you will hear about him again. He's very strong. So we extended it to, as one of recent results, we can do it the same way when B is in Ln. With in previous work we did it for bounded coefficients. We reduced it to case when we don't have lower order terms at all. Sorry, I took 3 minutes, but this is actually most recent and still. But formulation looks good, and also it is not known direct elliptic way to prove it. First, if you first extend to parabolic case, then do you think same as in elliptic, and then we get it as a byproduct. least it is not known to us. Okay, so this is all what I wanted to say.